In this problem, we've got an indefinite integral of a rational function. So this is a case where you should be thinking about using partial fractions. And I noticed right at the beginning that the degree of the numerator is bigger than the degree of the denominator. So I've got to use polynomial long division to simplify this thing before I proceed with partial fractions. So I'm all set up to do long division. I put in placeholders of 0x squared and 0. And then I'm guessing term by term the thing that I multiply x squared plus x minus 2 by to get x cubed plus 0x squared plus x plus 0. So it begins with a linear term because that's going to give me an x cubed. When I distribute x through this trinomial, I get x cubed plus x squared minus 2x. Now I subtract that guy and my x cubes are gone. And then I have a quadratic term of negative x squared and a linear term of x minus negative 2x. So plus 3x, and I'll go ahead and keep my placeholder of plus 0 there. Okay, now I move to my constant term, and if I put a negative 1 in here and distribute that to this trinomial, I'm going to get a negative x squared minus x plus 2, and I subtract this, and I get 4x minus 2. So that 4x minus 2 is the remainder, and what this means in terms of the original integral is that I can rewrite it as x minus 1 plus 4x minus 2 divided by x squared plus x minus 2. So the first two pieces of our integral are trivial. I just use the power rule for that. I get 1 half x squared minus x. And then this leftover integral, that's the piece we have to use partial fractions on. And I'm going to go ahead and factor the denominator while I'm working. So x squared plus x minus 2 factors into x plus 2 multiplied by x minus 1. So this is one of the simplest cases that you can have with partial fractions decomposition. What I do is propose a partial fractions decomposition for that rational expression, and all I need is two fractions, each one containing one of those linear factors. And I'm going to go ahead and multiply both sides of this by the least common denominator. And when I do that, the entire denominator on the left cancels out. The factor of x plus 2 cancels out for my first term on the right-hand side. So that leaves me with a times x minus 1. And the factor of x minus 1 cancels out for the second term, leaving me with b times x plus 2. And I can quickly find a and b this time by subbing in different values of x. So if I sub in x equals 1, then the left-hand side here becomes 2. The a containing term dies, and then the b containing term has a 3 stuck to it. Remember, I replaced x with 1, and I've immediately got b. Then using a similar trick, I sub in x equals negative 2, and then the b containing term will die. On the left-hand side, I get negative 8 minus 2, or negative 10. And on the right-hand side, I get a times negative 3, so a is going to be 10/3. All right, this means my integral can be re-expressed. Remember, our original partial fractions proposal can be re-expressed as 10/3 over x plus 2 plus 2/3 over x minus 1. And each of these pieces is guessable. It's just a natural log of the absolute value of the denominator. So I have a 10/3 natural log absolute value x plus 2 plus 2/3 natural log absolute value x minus 1. Don't forget there were a couple other pieces to this integral. So I'm going to put it all together and express our final answer. It was an indefinite integral, so there's got to be a plus c on there as well. So there's our final answer. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.